my god brother, Bahushira. He's not here, but he came yesterday. He wanted to make sure that you received some fruit offering from him. Thank you.
Oh, Nami. Nami.
I'll tell him that you got it directly.
Sansaradava.
Morning, sir?
Yes.
Sansaradava Nanalidhaloga Pranaya Khanda
Shut up.
तिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामने गौरतिशय हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमस्ते तप्त कंचन गौरांगी राधे बिंदावनेश्वरी विषभानुसुते प्रणमामि श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति सपदम् आद्दानस्तीणं दन्तैरिदं जाचे पुनः पुनः श्रीमद्रूपदं भोजधूरि श्याम जन्मनि Tenth श्लोक We have read this श्लोक and also some purport, some translation had been done. I want that you should read 87 page.
From the top?
After taking the devotional services.
Text 10 purport.
Where?
87.
Yes. 87 page. First paragraph left, second paragraph.
From second paragraph.
After taking to devotional service under the regulative principles, a person may come to the platform of spontaneous love of Godhead, following in the footsteps of great devotees like Narada and Sanak and Sanatan.
Can you explain why? He has told that service under the regulative principles, a person may come to the platform of a spontaneous love of Godhead. Why may he has done? May?
There's some doubt.
It's not guaranteed.
Why?
Because it is not guaranteed that just by practicing the Vaidhi Bhakti process that one will automatically come to Prabhupada.
I think that all are understanding this fact. He has told that may. He has not given guarantee for this. Those who will regulate, they will cultivate their regulative principles. And if they are coming in the association of any realized Rasik Bhakta in the line of Rupa Goswami, then they may be. Otherwise, lakhs and lakhs births doing this regulative principle, anyone cannot come. But we hope that we are fortunate to come in the line of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We like to be told Rupanuga Vaishnava. Why? Anyone can answer? Why we want to be Rupanuga? Why? Anyone? Govindapal Prabhu? Why we want to be Rupanuga Vaishnava and glorify that Swami Ji was Rupanuga Vaishnava?
Because Srila Rupa Goswami appearing in this world most recently is Srila Rupa Manjari and being so close to Krishna and following in his Krishna and Srimati Radhika, following so closely in his footsteps as Rupanuga Vaishnava, is the only way to obtain that kind of closeness, that kind of intimacy, that kind of bhakti.
Very good. Can you tell what is the difference between Raganuga and Rupanuga? You?
Raganuga means any of the rasas in Braj, such as Dasya, Sakya, Vatsalya, Madhurya. All of them have rag, they're all ragatmaka bhaktas. But Rupanuga specifically means those who are following Rupa Manjari serving Srimati Radhika.
Especially the mood of his own mood of Rupa Goswami. He has explained all kinds of rasas, all kinds of rati. Yes. But what was his special mood to Krishna? How he used to serve? How he used to serve? His own mood was what? If anyone will follow this, then he will be Rupanu, otherwise not. Vallabhacharya is not
Rupanu.
Sarup Damodar is not Rupanuga. What he is?
He is Ragatmik Jan, and in this world is
Sarup Damodar is himself.
Lalita.
Lalita. Rupa Goswami is under him. Rupa Goswami. His guru, Sarup Damodar. But yet he has a special service to Srimati Radhika, which is not in Lalita. He has equal service to Radhika and Krishna, if some inclination to Radhika. But Rupa totally absorbed in serving Srimati Radhika. This is the mood of Rupa Goswami. If anyone has the mood of Yashoda, if anyone has the mood of friends, Subal Sridham, if they have any mood of Lalita, Vishakha, Chitra, Ashta Sakhi, they are not Rupanuga. They are Raganuga. More superior than Rupa Goswami, Sarup Damodar Raya Ramanand, because they are Lalita and Vishakha. But we cannot follow Sarup Damodar and Raya Ramanand. We cannot follow Lalita and Vishakha. Their mood is separate. They are above our touch, and we don't want that. What we want?
Mood of
Rupa Goswami, Rupa Manjari. Always serving to happy in happiness of Radhika and
unhappy
in Srimati Radhika. Sometimes Lalita can chastise to Srimati Radhika. How?
Dhurte
brajendra tane tanu sushta bamme ma
dakshina bhava kalankini
radhavaya radhe sunu girahite amiti shikshayantin devin vlesh lalitang. Second tal, dhurte brajendra tane. Don't have any link with dhurta brajendra nandan. To whom he is telling?
Radhika.
Radhika. Don't speak. When he will come, you will sit like this. Don't. And if he wants to keep his head on your head, you should take your feet. Like this. Not seeing him. She can tell. When Radhika is observing Veera, quite Veera, Lalita will what? Pacify. Oh, you should not. Krishna is here. Like Sarup Damodar was telling to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, why you are lamenting for Brajandanandan? Brajandan is not far away from you. He is here. At once, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took his
nails.
And, oh, I will see. Oh, Brajandan is here. He became so happy. And he began. They took their hands. Rupa Goswami will not do. If Srimati Radhika is weeping, she will weep. Same thing with Radhika. When she is meeting with Krishna, she thinks that I am meeting with Krishna. She is happy, she will be unhappy. Equally, this is Raganuga. Rupanuga. Or Gurudev has made a Radha Vinodashtakam. The first sloka is like this, Rupanuga, not Raganuga. All Rupanuga are Raganuga, but all Raganugas are not
Rupanuga.
You should know this fact. What I'm telling?
All Rupanugas are Raganuga, but any Raganuga is not Rupanuga.
There are some. I'm not saying them. Some devotees are not. Oh, I was searching you. Can you explain what I told?
He said that everyone who's Rupanuga, who follows Rupa Goswami, they are Raganuga, but all of those who are Raganuga not having the same mood as Rupa Goswami.
Yes. Who are Rupanuga? Those are actually the following the mood of Rupa Goswami. So all acharyas are Rupanuga, not only Raganuga. So it is a very, very important thing. So our Guru has told, Radha Chintani Veshena Jashakantir Bilokita Sri Krishna Charanam Bande Radha Langita Vigraham. Meaning is this. Oh, try to understand, otherwise you will miss Govindapal Prabhu. You should hear these things. Otherwise, you will miss. Our Gurudev has written on the sloka. Radha Chinta Niveshena Jasya Kantri Vilokita. Sometimes Srimati Radhika becomes observed in
separation,
weeping bitterly. Sometimes they became faint. But Rupa Goswami does not want this. Or Gurudev Rupanuga, Raganuga, Rupanuga, or any other acharya, Rupa Goswami, will not want this. What he want? Radha Chinta Niveshena Jasya Kantri Bilokita. Krishna should be in the separation of Srimati Radhika. No? Krishna should be. Our Srimati Radhika is so soft, her feet are so soft. She should not walk here and there to search Krishna. Krishna should search, because he is cowherd boy. His feet are so?
Soul is so hard.
Hard. She should walk so much. So Radha Chinta Niveshana Jasya Kantri Vilokita. Srimati Radhika disappeared from Ras, and Krishna was searching. He had no darshan of Srimati Radhika, so he is searching, weeping. At last he sat down on Imlitala in Vrindavan, nearby
Jamuna
and Sevakund, and he was bitterly weeping. And he was observing, thinking, oh, where to have Srimati Radhika? Where to have Radhika? Where she has gone, left him here? And thinking, Krishna lost her black color, and at once he became like?
Golden color.
Krishna was there, but he became golden like Srimati Radhika. And his mood was changed into a Radhika mood. And he was then bitterly crying, oh Krishna, where you are? Oh Krishna, where you are? Understand this? Not calling Radhike, Radhike in the Harbira. But at once the color and mood came in him, and he began to call, Krishna, Krishna, where you are? This is the mood of our whole Vinod Bihari in our all maths, Guru has established there. with this mood. So Radha Chintanivesana Jashakantir Vilopita, his color, his mode went on. And he made him like golden color and mode of Radhika, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Radha Lingita Vigraham, I am doing Bandana to that very form of Krishna, which is, has been embraced by Radhika in all her part. Radhika, all party is there, and Krishna, all part of the body is covered by the all parts of Srimati Radhika. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Radha Lingita Vigraha. So, Radha Lingita Vigraha. This is Rupanuga. Krishna should be, Krishna should search Radhika. Why are this fake, innocent, very simple Srimati Radhika should go here and there in mountains, rivers, thrones? Why should go? Krishna should go all over searching. This is Rupanuga. So all Rupanuga Goswami are like this. They have come only to give these merciful things, only to bestow their mercy in this way. So Swamiji, he cut jungle, but he has not come to only cut jungles. So in this Rupa Goswami's teachings, instructions of nectar of instruction, he will give all these things. You should patiently hear. And you can tell that, oh, what is the mood of this special Raganuga Vaishnava, Raganuga Achar Siddha Swamiji, in the line of Rupa Goswami, Rupanuga Achar. Now then, after
the Supreme Personality of God. After taking to devotional service under the regulative principles, a person may come to the platform of spontaneous love of Godhead, following in the footsteps of great devotees like Narad and Sanak Sanatan.
Why he is taking Narad? Why he is taking? And Shankar, Sanak and Sanatan, they were all following the regulative bhaktis. But Narad, by the association of gopis, Uddhava also by the association of gopis, Sanak by Narad and by the grace of Uma Devi, wife of Shankar, they all came in a spontaneous love of service of Krishna. At first they were not like this. So he is setting examples. If anyone doing this regulative principles of bhakti, and by chance, by luck of the past impressions, or luckily without any cause, the mercy of Krishna, any devotee like will come and associate, and by hearing, by their association, following them, they will become like this. Narad, Sanak, Sanatan, like all these.
The Supreme Personality of Godhead then recognizes him to be superior. The devotees who have developed love of God are certainly in an exalted position. Of all these devotees, the gopis are recognized as superior because they do not know anything.
But he should know, he has told of all devotees, but gopis are not devotees. What they are?
They are aradhana devotees.
Expansion of Srimati Radhika, especially. Expansion. And some of them are like sadhana siddha, like Vedas, Shruti Mantra, and all others. But they are also honorable like them, like gopis, expansions of gopis. There is no difference there. In their grades, they are like same.
because they do not know anything other than satisfying Krishna. Mm. Nor do the gopis expect any return from Krishna. Mm. Indeed, sometimes Krishna puts them into extreme suffering by separating himself from them. Mm. Nonetheless, they cannot forget Krishna. Mm. When Krishna left Vrindavan for Mathura, the gopis became most dejected and spent the rest of their lives simply crying in separation from Krishna. Mm. This means that in one sense, they were never actually separated from Krishna. Mm. There is no difference between thinking of Krishna and associating with him.
What is the meaning? What is?
That thinking of Krishna is the same as direct association with Krishna. Krishna manifests himself to the devotee who is fully absorbed in him.
But why gopis are crying? Why they are crying? If both are same, but why crying so much, weeping, and sometimes faint? We cannot explain, but Krishna can explain. And Krishna has explained all these things in Brihad Bhagavatamritam to Narad himself. So Swamiji has told anywhere or written about Brihad Bhagavatamrita. What he has told? Written?
He says in one purport,
Adilila chapter 5.
Adilila?
Chapter 5.
What he has written?
He writes that if one wants to get an understanding of Krishna in relation to his devotees, he must read Brihad Bhagavatamrita.
Anyone cannot know the difference between Kanishta, Madhyam, and Uttam, and also Uttam Kanishta, Uttam Madhyam, Uttam, Uttam, or in these three, Uttam Kanishta, Uttam Madhyam, there are lakhs of what?
Stages.
If we can read Brihad Bhagavatam, any bona fide Vaishnava in the line of Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, then we can have these ideas. But now, we have nothing to do with Brihad Bhagavatamrita. If anyone read Brihad Bhagavatamrita, he will be Sahajiya. A very easy thing. If he will read the 10th Skanda, he will be Sahajiya. If anyone tell Gopi Gopi or Raganuga, even word, he will be Sahajiya. And that is why falling down. That always has been blocked. And they must return where they are first. Sometimes these persons make offense against bhakti, this raganuga. And that is why they never become qualified to hear and to read and to do anything. Forever they are what?
Disqualified.
Disqualified. They were vanchit rah jate hain.
Deprived.
They are deprived from these things. They never, I think that they have never read these things. Never, never. Otherwise they cannot tell all these things. Then?
Rather, Vipralamba Seva, thinking of Krishna in separation, as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did, is far better than serving Krishna directly.
This separation move. Very important, very important, very, very important. Sometimes this separation moods of gopis, not for all, I'm telling you, but gopis separation mood is sometimes become more superior than meeting sometimes. And they say Krishna always in their heart, always in their heart. In meeting, they lost in their heart Krishna. But in separation, they are losing Krishna outsidely, but they are meeting always with Krishna. So sometimes it becomes. But we should know that gopis cannot be satisfied without meeting Krishna and serving Krishna directly. They never want that Krishna should be separated to us. But Krishna does it. Why he makes all these things separation? Why he went? There are some things. So you should only know all these things. But by bhajan you try to develop your Krishna consciousness. Then you will be able to know all these things, realize something. Only my telling will not do. Never. So we'll have to practice and realize and chant more with love and affection in the line of Srila Rupa Goswami. We are telling that Rupanu Guru Varga ki jai daily. But never, have you ever questioned that what is Rupanuga? Why you are glorifying? Your Gurudev was Rupanuga or Raganuga only, or not even both. He was only regulative bhar, regulative doing always and preaching. He never preached like so. We are telling. And we are telling that he was Rupanuga. Why Rupanuga? Anyone can ask this question. Why Rupanuga? He will know. He will try to know what is Rupanuga, who is Rup, what is his mood, why, how we can adopt his mood. This is not offensive. If he is not doing so, it is offensive. Being in the line of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Go on.
Thus, of all the devotees who have developed unalloyed devotional love for Krishna, the gopis are most exalted. And out of all these exalted gopis, Srimati Radharani is the highest. No one can excel the devotional service of Srimati Radharani. Indeed, even Krishna cannot understand the attitude of Srimati Radharani.
No. How highest? How highest? If anyone cannot be qualified to hear all these things and to have a mood like this, then what he will do? Well, he will tell that, oh, anyone is not qualified and will never be qualified in future. This is offense in the lotus feet of
devotees.
Bhakti, Krishna himself and Radharani also. That is why they will become more and more opposite. No one can.
Therefore, he took her position and appeared as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu just to understand her transcendental feelings. In this way, Srila Rupa Goswami gradually concludes that Srimati Radharani is the most exalted devotee of Krishna, and that her kunda, lake, Sri Radha Kunda, is the most exalted place. This is verified in a quotation from Laghu Bhagavatamrita, Uttarakhanda 45,
yes.
as quoted in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Just as Srimati Radharani is dear to the Supreme Lord Krishna, Vishnu, so her bathing place, Radha Kunda, is equally dear to Krishna. Among all the gopis, she alone stands supreme as the Lord's most beloved. Therefore, everyone interested in Krishna consciousness should ultimately take shelter of Radha Kunda.
What he is telling? Therefore, everyone, man. What is the meaning of everyone? Can we tell, ask this question to anyone? What is the meaning of everyone? If anyone has been liberated and gone to Vrindavan in their transcendental form, they can have this idea. He has written like this. No. So he has told, therefore, anyone interested in Krishna consciousness And those who are not interested in Krishna consciousness, they are bogus person. They should not have this idea. Otherwise, everyone who are interested in Krishna consciousness should ultimately take shelter of Srimati Radha Kunda and Radha. He is telling everyone. And we are making so many vows in these, yes, what?
Instructions.
Instructions. So there is no vow. The vows are false. So anyone who is certainly interested in Krishna consciousness will follow this idea. And those who are not Krishna consciousness, not Krishna conscious movement, they should not do. This is the
guideline.
So those who are not interested, they are not Krishna consciousness. And actually those who are following this statement, they are really Krishna consciousness.
And execute devotional service there throughout one's life.
For whole life they will do. This is very hopeful line. Very hopeful line. Those who are not following these lines, they are going down. They must go down. There is no way. Their all ways are blocked. This is the
conclusion of Rupa Goswami in the 10th verse of Upadeshamrita.
Yes, very good thing. Krishna shochai pranaya vasati preyasya bhiradhika kundam chasya munibhiravita tadrigeva vyadhai yat preshtairapi asulabham kem punar bhakti bhajam tat premedam sagritapi sarasasnatu ravishkarotu. Last slok. What is the translation?
Of the many objects of favored delight and of all the lovable damsels of Brajabhumi, Srimati Radharani is certainly the most treasured object of Krishna's love.
What is the meaning? Can you explain what is the meaning of this line?
Srimati Radharani is Radini Shakti, fully manifest.
Of the many objects of the favored delight and of all the lovable damsels of Brajabhumi, Srimati Radharani is certainly the most treasured object of Krishna love. What is the meaning of object of Krishna love? What? Object of Krishna means?
She is the most lovable object. Krishna has so many objects, meaning his cowherd boys, cows, so many Vrajagopis, the trees, the Yamuna, everything.
They're Krishna love? What is the meaning of Krishna love?
There's Ashoya Vigraha and Vishoya Vigraha. No?
Krishna love. The love towards Krishna, unto Krishna. Srimati Radhika has that thing. How to love Krishna? How to please Krishna? So, our object should be like this. Like Rupa Goswami, he has written. First we should know who is Krishna. Who is Krishna? The beloved of Radhika. Don't take Krishna your beloved. You should think that my Aradhya Devi is Srimati Radhika. We want his mood. We cannot take solely his mood, her mood, partly. And what is that partly mood of Srimati Radhika? The mood of Roop. We can take only this. So our object of a whole devotion is to serve Srimati Radhika. This is. And take partly her mood to serve Krishna, like Rupa Goswami. Rupa Goswami has not served Krishna solely as Srimati Radhika. He has served Srimati Radhika. No? If he wanted, he has served Krishna like so, because he was himself Naika, not less than any gopi. But they never thought of this, to be any Naika. Naika, you know?
Heroine.
Like Lalita, Vishakha, Chitra, Champaklata, Shyamla, Bhadra, Chandra, they are all Naikas. But Lalita Vishakha and Rupa Goswami and all other Goswami never wanted to serve Krishna like them, only like Rupa Goswami, always serving Srimati Radhika. And her guidance, if she will tell anything, they will do. This is Rupanubhava. So object, treasured object of Krishna love. Treasure means treasury.
Sampatti khajana.
So much affluence and
wealth
there. We cannot take all, but some one, two jewels of Radhika treasure. And that is Rupanuga jewel we can take. It is most valuable. It covers all. But we can realize, if we will serve any Vaishnava living in the world, having these modes, then we can have. Our life will be successful. Our object of all bhakti is that. What? That's Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur has told. Or what object? We want to be the lotus dust of the lotus feet of Rupa Manjari. This song in the departures of Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami in Vrindavan, Samadhi place. Why I sang? That sometimes in Mathura and everywhere I saw that. He used to appreciate this song so much when I used to sing. So I thought that this was very, very
dear
to Swami. In Mathura and everywhere I used to sing this Gita. He liked to hear this song. So I sung that at that very time. That he is hearing. Sirupa Manjari Pada. Shai Mora?
Sampada.
Sampad means?
Wealth.
Oh, this Sampad here, treasury. In Srimati Radhika's treasure, this Sampati is there. We can have. How can? By serving Rupa Manjari. Srimati Radhika with. Keep this jewel. No? How he has taken all these things from Rupa Goswami and all these epics and all these books. I wonder how. This is the glory of Swamiji. And the glories which we are going to tell are not really glory. He was so bairagi.
Renunciate.
He had nothing to do with any worldly things. These are not glories. In their eyes, it may be glory. But this is second thing. He preached all over world the name. This is glory, but secondary, thirdly, fourthly. We cannot realize. This thing which he is giving here, he wants to give a jewel from the treasured object of Krishna love, where he is, in the Radhika heart. And he has come to give this special thing. Who will glorify in this way? To Swamiji? This is the highest glory of Swamiji. But I think rare are in this world are person that they can touch even the glory of Swamiji. It was given by Swarup Damodar to Rupa Goswami, and Rupa Goswami gave it to Jiva Goswami, Raghunath Goswami. Kindly, mercifully, he gave to Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. And it went in the hands of Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. And thus came to in the hands of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur and Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. And from his hands, some little jewels he gave to Swamiji. Gave it to world. But very rare are. You are willing to give, but they will not take. They will refuse. And we want that thing. What thing? So no harm. Even something they are taking. I think that when we will be in association of any these kinds of bhakta, then you can touch the glory of Swami. Go on.
And in every respect, her divine kunda is described by great sages as similarly dear to him. Undoubtedly, Radha Kunda is very rarely attained, even by the great devotees. Therefore, it is even more difficult for ordinary devotees to attain. If one simply bathes once within those holy waters, one's pure love of Krishna is fully aroused.
He hath given hope. And we should trust in his words. Purport.
Why is Radha Kunda so exalted? The lake is so exalted because it belongs to Srimati Radharani.
This Kunda is herself Srimati Radhika, not belongs to
this world.
He has told only to understand, make understand, that easily we can understand this thing. Radha Kunda is herself Radhika and Krishna Kunda is
himself Krishna.
Rupa Goswami has told that, even more than that, Krishna and Radhika, this Kunda. Because they are seen, we can touch, we can take bath in this, but we cannot realize transcendental Krishna and Radhika. So they are more
merciful
to us. If you are knowing the glory of Radha Kunda and Shyam Kunda, but even we will go there with honor, we will take water and sprinkle. We will take bath there. Or we can glory Srimati Radhika. Radhika will be so much placed, shortened. And we can have this. You can realize it going there or here living. Radha Kunda, Radha Kunda, and in mind you are taking bath and thinking of Radha Kunda, something will come.
In our conditioned state, are we really touching Radha Kunda when we bathe there?
Really are not, where our heart is something touching? No heart. No heart. They are so powerful. Because Narada has benediction for this.
Yeah.
That any place of your Krishna,
pastimes.
Anyone touch will see by hear, by touching by ears, eyes, body, Krishna Prem. You will have to give. You are bound to give. Krishna says, yes, I am bound.
Among all the gopis, she is the most beloved. Similarly, her lake, Sri Radha Kunda, is also described by the great...
Come on here. In the last, the conclusion is that
Page number?
Page number 91, 5, 6 line.
The conclusion is that to live on the banks of Radha Kunda and to bathe there daily constitute the highest perfection of devotional service. It is a difficult position to attain, even for great sages and devotees like Narada. Thus, there is no limit to the glory of Sri Radha Kunda. By serving Radha Kunda, one can get an opportunity to become an assistant of Srimati Radharani under the eternal guidance of the gopis.
This is the conclusion. We have no time to explain all words. Each and every words of nectar of instruction should be explained. But we have no time to explain all this. Without explaining and following, we cannot realize these things. But even we should hear and we should know, this is the object of our whole devotional life. And this is the highest thing. And keeping this object in our heart, we should begin from beginning. What? That Raghunath Das Goswami has told in Manasikha. Gurau goste goshtalaisu sujane bhusurgane samantre si namni brajajuvadanta sarane sadadam ham hitva kurumapyampam ratitaramaye vratas chatupirate dhitipadaha. Like this. This sloka is so important. If you are not going to follow, you cannot enter in all these things. Because Raghunath Goswami is most dear and Rupanuga Vaishnava. If he will take shelter of Raghunath Das Goswami, he will make any way that we can enter in this nectar of instruction. Otherwise, no. So we should have this sloka remembered in our always in here. Where?
That's right.
You should remember and try to do all things. This is the mercy. Maharaj, you should be merciful to me. Maharaj, you should be merciful to me. Gurudev, you should be merciful to me. And this is the mercy. You should take this. All your what problems we go. No problem there. Those who want to serve Krishna, the only problem, how to have Krishna service. Only this. And if it is solved, everything is solved. So we should not be so in so much problems. Always problem, problem, problem. No problem. Only problem is this. If it is solved, everything is solved. World may give up us, no harm. Whole world can give up, no harm. But I know that Krishna will never forget us. Never will do. He has told that rejected by whole world, even by Guru also, so-called Guru. If so-called Guru gives up his most qualified devotees, he is so-called Guru. So so-called Guru, mother, father, husband, wife, children, and whole world can give up anyone. But those who have given up all these things for me, I can never give up them. So you will have to trust in these Krishna words. Sarva dharmana parityajya mam ekam saranam braja. Ekam mam ekam. To me only. Then I never have any problem for them. If Arjun, if you are killing Bhisham Pitama, you are killing your Gurudev, whom?
Dronacharya
and Kripacharya, Aswatthama. You are killing your brother, Duryodhan, Dushasan, and all 100. If you are killing those who are your relative, but against you and they are in the party of Duryodhan, you will kill everyone, but nothing. I will take all these things, but don't be worried for this. how this good thing is there? We'll have to trust, otherwise how we can go develop in Krishna consciousness? More than that, Krishna has told so many things. So we should follow, if we want to be like this. First, this is the mercy, my mercy, Rupa Goswami mercy, Gurudev mercy, everything is there. Mahaprabhu mercy, Guru Goshte Goshthalesu, Sujanesh Bhusuragane, Swamantreshi Namni Brajvadanda Sarani, Sada Dambham Hitva. Dambham means false ego. I am very beautiful lady, I am very beautiful young person, I am so intelligent, I am so wealthy, I am so qualified. Give up all this. I am Indian, I am Brajavasi. If you are not paying Dakshina, I will give you a course. You should be taught twice. Like this. Your sarvanasha is going on. Sarvanasha, you know?
Destruction.
Sarvanasha.
Will be destroyed.
Some Brajavasi tell like this. You should pay me first dakshina. Ki bole sab. Lakshmi, Lakshmi. These are not all Brajavasi. Guru goshte goshtalesu sujane bhusa. Guru. Who is Guru? Those who have taken something, some jewels from the treasure of
Rupa Goswami Pad.
Radhika. Here we are told. And what is that jewel?
Mood of Rupa.
To serve Srimati Radhika like this is jewel. Those who have this jewel, they can give you. Other they who have no jewels like this, how can they give? They will tell only what they have realized, bring money to make mandir, and I am giving visa to you and you will directly go there. This is the main object of Prabhupada, he can. I think they have not touched the glory of Swamiji. So if in they have jewel like these things from the treasure house of Srimati Radhika, Guru, his Guru. Guru Goshthe. Guru giving this thing is Guru. And he is taking everything, all wealth, all reputation, all services from devotees, and not clearing, not making pure our heart to offer in the lotus feet of Radhika, then he is actually no guru. To Guru. What Guru? What Guru?
Cow.
You have honor. You have to serve. Guru, Ghoshthe. Ghost means? What is the meaning of ghost? Where Krishna lives. Nandagaon, Varsana, Mayapur, Gambhira, all ghosts. But especially in Brajabhumi, Nandagaon, Varsana, Radhakund, all are ghosts. We'll have to honor. Ghoste, ghost alayesu. Those who live in ghosts, Nanda Baba, Jasoda, Sridham, Sumang, Madhumangal, and all the gopis. Goshtha Lesu Sujane. Sujane means here. Sujane?
In our Vaishnava, but not in our Sampradaya, in another Sampradaya.
Sujane they are. Like Madhvacharya, Ramanuj, they are Sujane. Serving Krishna in other form. And Goshtha Lesu, Rupa Sanatan, or our Goshtha Lesu. Like Brajvasi, not Brajvasi today. Brajvasi like Nanda, Jasoda, Subal, Sridham, Gopis. And also you should serve, like devotees like Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami in their life. sujane, any sampradaya Vishnu. Devotee living in Vrindavan, residing in Vrindavan. But they are not Brajavasi. But they are sujan, sajjana. But not Brajavasi. Who are Brajavasi? In the mood of gopis, they are Brajavasi. Having birth in Vrindavan, Brajbhumi, they are not Brajavasi. If they are mood of gopis, being anywhere in this world, they are Brajavasi. Sujane, bhu surgane, bhu brahmin. They are brahmin. They are serving Krishna, but with Krishna they are serving also so many demigods. But still they should be given some honor. Then, bhu surgane, swamantre. If you want to develop your Krishna consciousness, the mantra given by your Gurudev. Try to know the mood of the mantra and punctually, daily, you should try to do how he has told you to do. And then Mahamantra Hare Mantre, Swamantre, Guru has given that mantra. What mantra? Himself, Radha and Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama. This mantra. And Radha Krishna conjugal. Give him all kinds of false egos and false walls and everything. Give him. You should have so much honor with a priti rati. You should do such all these things, what we have told, what Raghunath Das Goswami. Then you will see that very soon you will develop Krishna consciousness. This is mercy. If you want to take my mercy or any Rupanuga Vaishnava or anything, this is the mercy you should try and see. This will solve all kinds of problem. Gaur Pramanande Rupa Goswami ki
Jai.
Guru Parampara ki
Jai.
You should sing any kirtan.
Yashomati nandana Brajavarana Guru
Yashomati nandana Brajavarana
Yashomati nandana Brajavarana
Guru
Oh,
Thank you.